A new Netflix docu-series debuted yesterday detailing how Aaron Hernandez went from star tight end for the New England Patriots to convicted killer. The documentary used interviews from those who knew Hernandez throughout his life to explore his disturbing path. Hernandez died in prison in 2017 after being found guilty of the murder of his future brother-in-law in 2013. Shannon, I know you watched the whole thing. I watched some of it as well. What did you learn from this?
Skip, I will never, ever make excuses for someone that did what Aaron Hernandez did. I will never have sympathy for someone, even though he ended up taking his own life. I'll never have sympathy for someone that made the choices that he made. But watching that, it gave me a glimpse of what set him on the path in which he ultimately chose. I think two things for me, watching this in its entirety, and I'm going to go back and watch it again to make sure I didn't miss anything. Two things. The death of his father and what his mom immediately did after the death of his father. Those were the culmination of Skip. And if you get, as you get into it, Jenny, you will see that he's talking to his mom. You don't know what you did to me. You ruined me. And she doesn't understand. Oh, come on, Aaron. Stop it. She doesn't see what she did and what caused the pain that he was suffering. I believe the reason why he gravitated towards his cousin, because it was the husband that the mom took.
That is true.
So he can sympathize with her pain because he was in so much pain for what his mom did. Leaving mom dead, because that was her way of thumbing a finger up at the husband before what, because they said he was somewhat abusive to her.
He was, according to the documentary.
Yes. Skip, he was dealing with a lot of things. I did not know this, that he, if it's to be true, his quarterback in high school, and he had a sexual relationship. Now, there are a lot of professional sports in America, like football, in the free football, basketball, and baseball. But none of them is more testosterone-driven than football. And Skip, there's a machismo, there's an image that comes along with that. There's a reason why they say it's on the down low, in the closet. Because the last thing you want to have happen is something of that nature to come out. Especially, you're a football, Skip, not just a football player. You're a bench warmer, okay, you're a guy. He's the guy in high school.
Player of the year in Connecticut.
Player of the year. And so, Skip, that sent him on a path. Not to excuse it, because, Skip, you know, the environments play a huge part, good and bad. Skip, you notice I get on here and I talk a lot about my grandmother, my grandfather. I talk about my upbringing, because they had a positive impact. My grandfather died when I was 8 years old, so there was no dominant male figure voice in the house. That could have been a time that me and my brother like, what you gonna do, Granny? You can't do anything with us. We already your size. But we chose to be on our best behavior. When his father passed, that was his opportunity to do what the hell he wanted to do, because his father kept his foot on his neck. Because his father, it's also said in the docuseries that he was very close to some cousins and he wanted to be a cheerleader. And his dad said, oh, no, hell, you not. Skip. He also, when he went, and I think the thing is, when his father died, because it was supposed to be a package deal, his brother was already quarterback at UConn. That's where he was supposed to go.
His father played at UConn, was a legendary star at Bristol Central High School, ahead of Aaron.
And so once his father passed, his mother did what she did. He's like, I need to get the hell away from here. I'm going to go as far away from you as I possibly can. So his mom is on one end of 95 in Connecticut. He's on the other end of 95 down in Gainesville, Florida.
Which is crazy, that part.
He gets to Florida and he's like, well, hold on. I'm catching passes. I'm doing things. I can get away with stuff here. Bartender asks, hey, bro, you got a tab here. Bop, punches him in the ear, busts his eardrum. Now, Skip, in the South, a lot of these colleges are in small towns. They're college towns. Do you really want to be the guy that press charges on Aaron Hernandez, gets him kicked off the team, or gets him suspended where he can't play? So he started to understand these things. Listening at him talk while he was in jail, and he's talking to his mom, and he's talking to his fiance, and Skip, he had an anger issue, no question about that. And his fiance calls him and says, Aaron, they came here and they searched the house again, and he doesn't understand why she's upset. She said, because they keep doing this. And he's like, well, at least you got your freedom. He's like, you caused that. You brought, not only did you bring that on yourself, you brought that on me. And he's like, what are you upset about? He hangs the phone up on her. So, Skip, it offered me a glimpse into what started this. But, Skip, no matter what, I can get in my car and start going somewhere. But I can also make a choice, say, you know what? I'm going to turn and go left, and I'm going to go back home. I'm going to turn and go right. Mm-hmm. But he proceeded down the road that led him to where it led him. So, Skip, I'm not offering excuses because it was a choice. I have no sympathy because I believe three people lost their lives.
So do I.
The double murder, he got acquitted of.
Yeah. Yeah.
But Odin Lloyd, we know for a fact.
They did point out that the car involved in the double murder was in his cousin's garage, and they discovered it two years later. And they've been searching the countryside for it, mm-hmm. right?
And his cousin was so loyal, mm-hmm. it ended up costing her life because she's dealing with cancer.
Yeah.
And she would, and you know you're not going to get the treatments that you would get in jail that you would get outside. Mm. But she wrote it out. She wouldn't budge because they had that bond. Skip, I believe they had a bond because of what they shared. It was her husband and it was his mom that did what they did, and they bonded. It was her house that he could go to and do whatever he wanted to do.
Yep.
Because that wasn't allowed mm-hmm. at home.
And that was the first place he started to fall in with the wrong people.
Mm-hmm.
And then when he went to Gainesville, he fell in with worse people, right?
Yep.
Okay, so we are right now on a slippery slope. And I'm glad you prefaced what you said with your concerns about this slippery slope, because just me, I learned a whole lot about Aaron Hernandez last night I did not know.
I think a lot of people did.
Did that create any sympathy in me? Not an ounce of sympathy.
Zero.
He shot and killed in cold blood a friend of his.
Right.
And then to your point, I believe he had something to do with the killing of the other two earlier.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
So I learned a lot more about the why of Aaron Hernandez, mm-hmm. the why for his precipitous fall from grace and the New England Patriots and the big he got a contract, a second deal with them, $40 million, a 5-year, $40 million deal, right in the middle. It was 2 days after that, the double murder, right?
Skip,
what?
The timing.
Okay. Skip, about to cut you off, but people don't realize how good Aaron Hernandez was.
Oh,
he and Gronk came in the same year. He missed two games. He had more catches and more yards than Gronk in his rookie season.
He did.
That's how good he was.
Wow. He was a force for that team. He was gifted.
He was Travis Kelce. He was George Kittle before there because he had wiggle. He could do that. Gronk was the power guy. But this guy could run routes. Skip, you remember against the Broncos, they put him in the backfield and they tossed him the ball. He went 45 yards.
Well, the Tebow playoff game after Tebow beat Pittsburgh, he had to go to Foxborough.
Right.
And he got annihilated because Aaron Hernandez took the game over.
They lined him up at tailback and pitched him the ball. And that's a tight end doing that.
And they got him in the fourth round. Why did they get him? Because everybody knew about all the off the field at Gainesville.
A lot of people took him off their board.
Okay, and I'm going to get to that in just a moment. But again, back to your point, slippery slope. I did learn a lot of the why, but we've all been through things. I had a terrible childhood. Mm-hmm. You can read it on my Facebook page. Here I am. It was not pretty, but was it a reason for me to go shoot something? No.
Absolutely
and to
not.
Your point, then you have to go north or south.
Right.
What are you going to do? And I guess he wasn't equipped to go north.
Right.
But I don't have any sympathy for him, but I'm enlightened as to the why.
Correct.
Yeah.
Because the most shocking of all came the on-camera interview with his high school quarterback.
Yep.
And the young man was just forthright about, we had a relationship.
Yep.
And they also had his father on camera, who was a corrections officer, mm-hmm. who was also very sympathetic then to his son. I wish I'd been more supportive. Mm-hmm. I didn't know.
Yeah.
But the son was making it very clear that he and Aaron were horrified at the prospect of anybody finding out that the two stars at Bristol Central High School were having a relationship.
Right.
And that Aaron was horrified that his father would find out because he was domineering, as you say, and occasionally abusive. And I did the note that just came and went, and I'm interested that you picked up on it, fascinated, was at one point he wanted to be a cheerleader.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And his father nixed that idea like that.
Yes.
You would think that he would.
Yes.
So he's following in his father's legendary footsteps. And I know Bristol Central. I drove by it 1,000 times because I spent so much time at ESPN in Bristol, Connecticut. Mm-hmm. And it's not a bad neighborhood. It's a middle-classy sort of neighborhood.
Right.
And it's a really good high school that sent a lot of kids to a lot of big schools mm-hmm. academically. It's a good place.
Right.
So it's not that he came from a really bad neighborhood. Nope, that's not what was going on.
Right.
But at home, a lot of things were going on. And then his father died when he was 16. And that sent him spinning because he lost the discipline, the structure that his father provided in his life. So the bad was actually good for Aaron because it formed a bond between them, but also he was afraid of him, so it kept him on the straight and narrow.
Because what the high school quarterback says, when his dad would come around, Aaron would say, okay, I got to straighten up.
Okay. So if his dad had stayed alive, would it have helped save Aaron? I don't know. Maybe.
Right.
Possibly.
Right.
Okay, so then two things happen because of the bisexual relationship that they are reporting in the Netflix documentary. There's speculation that Odin Lloyd, a good friend of his, knew about his bisexuality.
Right.
And he feared, Aaron feared, that Odin Lloyd might tell his girlfriend, who is the sister of Aaron's fiance, who is the mother of his daughter.
Correct.
And that horrified him enough that he finally said, I've got to end his life.
Right.
Right?
Right.
And then there's also speculation that when a Newsweek reporter went on WEEI radio in Boston 2 days before Aaron took his own life in prison.
Right.
And she disclosed on air that he had a prison boyfriend.
Right.
That somehow that got back to Aaron, and just the shame of it, the embarrassment of him. There's speculation that helped spur him to take
his life. Because, Skip, you could hear him when he's talking to his fiance. Yep. And he's talking about it and them.
Yeah.
And she said, don't say that. They're transgender. They're people just like you.
No, that was to his mom, I think.
No, that was his fiance. Well,
it's at one point he was disparaging to gays in prison to his mom.
I think it was, it might've been his mom, but I think,
okay,
I know.
Whatever, right? He was on the phone.
Right,
yes.
Right,
yes.
And she's explaining, they're people like you.
Correct.
And it seemed like he was going overboard.